everlasting life. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends.
To suffer and to die.
for you, for me, for all humanity. The tomb was also real, and inside that tomb, Jesus lay lifeless and still. But the power of God won the victory over death and darkness. The tomb is forever empty. Jesus is alive. And because he lives, we too have life. We are freed from sin and the grave, free to serve the living Lord. We do not grieve over his death. We celebrate his life. He is alive, and now is the time to celebrate.
Thank you. day of celebration. A day when we have lived throughout the week. We have watched Mary wash his feet. We have heard the story of him gathering in the upper room. We have walked to Golgotha with him. And we have heard the silence of the stone sealing the tomb. But today we come here to celebrate. We come here to celebrate that the stone was rolled away. The stone was rolled away. Mary and her friends, they ran to the tomb when they heard, when she had discovered the stone was rolled away. The disciples ran to the tomb. And Mary went back with them, and she looked inside, and two angels were in there. And they said, "Do not worry, for he is not dead. They have not taken his body." And then, presuming it was the gardener that was speaking to her, she said, "Where have you taken him? Wherever you take him, I want to anoint his body." She still loved him like we still love him. And he said something to her. Bob Goff said that Jesus preached the shortest sermon with the most powerful impact by preaching a sermon of one word. It happened on this day. When Mary was at the tomb, he said this to her. He said, "Mary." The scripture tells us that when she heard those words, she recognized immediately who it was that was speaking to her. She did not recognize his physical form, so we don't know what the resurrected Christ looked like. But she recognized his voice of love, the voice of God, the voice that knew her and called her by name, the voice that knows you and calls you by name. On this Resurrection Sunday, on this Easter, when we celebrate the risen Christ, I wonder, what do you hear being said? Are you busy with Easter egg hunts? Are you busy with family gatherings? Are you busy with family issues that arise and you must care for them? And you can't hear God call your name? We are no different than Mary. We have discovered the risen Christ. And we continue to discover the risen Christ anew in our lives every day. And every day, the risen Christ calls us by name and invites us to remember the holy moment of when they discovered his resurrection. The holy moment of God's mighty work, defeating death. Christ calls us by name every day and says, "You are my disciples. There is room for you at the table. Believe, and you will be with me in eternity." We come to this table today believing that God has prepared a place for us. And we believe that God calls us by name and claims us as his own. And through his work in the power of the Holy Spirit, and through his work in Jesus the Christ, we are made one with him. We believe in the disciples of Christ, the Christian church disciples of Christ, that this table is open to all people. There are no boundaries here, just like there were no boundaries on that resurrection day. God calls you by name, invites you to come and sit at the table, to break the bread, and to drink the cup, and know that you are Christ. For we know that on that day he broke the bread with the disciples and said to them, "Take and eat, for this is my body which will be given for you." And he took the cup and he offered it to them, and he said to them, "Drink from this cup. It is the cup of the new covenant. It shall be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sin." So as often as we eat these elements and participate with the Spirit of God with us, we experience the presence of the living Christ in our lives. You are invited.
to come and partake. Let us pray. O God, who knows our name, O God, who worked so many years ago through Jesus for us, come and sit with us as we gather around your table on this high holy day. Come and be with us. Though we may not want to be seen by you, we know you see us. Pour out your love and grace. Give us your dose of mercy, though we feel we don't deserve it. And allow us to drink deeply of the cup of the new covenant. Allow us to experience resurrection. Allow us to know the truth of our salvation. And allow us to walk with you wherever we go. Come be with us in these holy moments. Sit with us at this table, and let us experience the living Christ in him. This is our prayer in the name of Jesus the Christ, and all of God's people say, Amen. Amen. The table of the Lord is set. Won't you please partake?